بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هنتكلم النهاردة عن محاضرة Congenital Infections. أنا الدكتور محمد نصار، مدرس طب الأطفال وحديث الولادة. Case 1: A newborn has bilateral cataract, microphthalmia, intrauterine growth retardation, hemorrhagic skin lesions scattered through the body, with harsh systolic murmur heard at the left sternal border. What is the most likely diagnosis؟ قبل ما نتكلم في تشخيص الحالة، هنتكلم عموما عن الكونجنتال انفكشن، اللي اختصارها ان احنا بنتكلم عليها اللي هي التورش، اللي هو ترانس بلاسنتال انترايوترين انفكشن، which are typically acquired in the first or second trimester. Most infants have intrauterine growth retardation. Differential diagnosis of congenital infection. Many of findings of torch infection are very similar, so the most likely presentation will be discussed. Toxoplasmosis infection. The baby has hydrocephalus with generalized calcification and chorioretinitis. In rubella infection, the classic finding of cataract, deafness, and heart defect. In cytomegalovirus infection, there is microcephaly with periventricular calcification, petechiae with thrombocytopenia, hepatosplenomegaly, and sensorineural hearing loss. In herpes infection, there is skin vesicle keratoconjunctivitis, acute meningoencephalitis. In syphilis, there is osteochondritis with periostitis. Skin rash involving the palm and the sole, which is desquamating. Snuffle, which is mucopurulent rhinitis. So again to our case, a newborn has bilateral cataract, microphthalmia, intrauterine growth retardation, hemorrhagic skin lesion, which are scattered through the body with harsh systolic murmur heard in the left sternal border. What is the most likely diagnosis? The answer is congenital rubella. In congenital rubella, the classic finding when maternal infection occur in the first 8 weeks of gestation. Blueberry muffin spot due to extramedullary hematobiosis, thrombocytopenia, cardiac lesion include BDA, referral pulmonary artery stenosis. In the eye, there is cataract, there is congenital hearing loss, thrombocytopenia, and hepatosplenomegaly. The outcome of congenital rubella include hearing loss, persistent growth retardation, microcephaly, mental and motor retardation. Case number 2. A newborn has hydrocephalus, chorioretinitis, intracranial calcification, and anemia. What is the most likely diagnosis? The answer is congenital toxoplasmosis. Toxoplasmosis is a maternal infection worldwide due to primary ingestion of undercooked or raw meat containing tissue cysts, ingestion of water or food with oocytes that have been excreted in infected cat, fecal contamination is the most common form of transmission. Advice: the pregnant woman not to change clean cat litter while pregnant. Finding in toxoplasmosis infection include jaundice, hepatosplenomegaly, thrombocytopenia and anemia, microcephaly, chorioretinitis, hydrocephalus, intracranial calcification and seizure. The outcome include psychomotor retardation, seizure disorder, and visual impairment. Case number 3. A newborn with microcephaly, intracranial calcification, hepatosplenomegaly, marked hyperbilirubinemia, and thrombocytopenia. What is the most likely diagnosis? The answer is congenital cytomegalovirus. Primary infection with cytomegalovirus or maybe due to high risk of severe infection or reactivation. The findings are hepatitis splenomegaly and jaundice, preventricular calcification, intrauterine growth retardation, chorioretinitis, microcephaly, thrombocytopenia, and hemolytic anemia. The outcome of cytomegalovirus include sensorineural hearing loss, neuromuscular abnormality, and intellectual disability. Case number 4, a newborn with a skin vesicle, keratoconjunctivitis, and acute meningoencephalitis. What is the most likely diagnosis of this case? The answer is congenital herpes simplex. In herpes simplex, there is keratoconjunctivitis, affection of skin from 5 to 14 days. After that, CNS infection from 3 to 4 weeks with dissemination. Best diagnosis by PCR from any body fluid. And the best treatment is intravenous acyclovir. Outcome, microcephaly, spasticity, deafness, blindness, seizure disorder, psychomotor retardation and death. And the treatment is by acyclovir. Summary, many of findings of torch infection are very similar. So, note that the most likely presentation in toxoplasmosis, hydrocephalus with generalized calcification and chorioretinitis. In rubella infection, the classic finding of cataract deafness and heart defect. In cytomegalovirus, microcephaly with preventricular calcification, petechiae with thrombocytopenia, hepatitis splenomegaly, and sensorineural hearing loss. In herpes, there is skin vesicles, keratoconjunctivitis, and acute meningoencephalitis. And lastly, in syphilis, osteochondritis, and periostitis with skin rash involving balm and sole and presence of snuffles. And thank you.